Today, the government made it clear London Underground will not get all the extra money they want to stop the system rotting away. The response was one of bitter disappointment and that London will be left with a deteriorating railway. The government also said they'll not allow fare rises more than 2.5% above inflation. This year, £370 million is being invested in the Tube. The Underground say they need at least double that amount every year for the next decade. Both the government and the Underground were responding to a Monopolies and Mergers Commission report, which said the Tube was suffering from 30 years of chronic underfunding and needed a massive injection of cash.
I'm saying there must be a limit, and I'm answerable as a junior minister through my bosses to the taxpayers as a whole. And we have a very big investment program in Greater London, part of it in Docklands, but a big investment program. And there must be a finite limit to how much we can achieve in a short period of time. But we've got a good record. Don't let's run away from giving credit to London Transport and the government for funding a big investment program in recent years.
The effects of underfunding on the Tube are getting worse by the day. Stations are beginning to crumble. 40 sections of track have speed restrictions because money for repairs has run out. At Charing Cross on the Northern Line, trains have to crawl along.
And there's yet more evidence that Tube passengers are having to suffer because London Underground has insufficient funds. This escalator hasn't worked for the last year, as this sign clearly points out.
Waterloo Station is a disgrace. Water seepage is causing serious structural problems. Above £100 million is being spent on a new passenger terminal for the Channel Rail link. The fear below is there'll be no money to upgrade the station, which will have to cope with an extra 2,000 passengers an hour.
If we don't get this money, we fail to deliver a decently modern metro. That means that this city has a substandard transport service. Given that the Underground is vital to London, it produces negative implications for business and the community at large.
Big improvements to the Central Line and a new Cross London Rail link are on the way, but London Underground say their campaign for more cash will continue. With little prospect of a big increase, improvements to much of the existing system will be limited, if at all. This is Mike Pearce for Thames News.